In his letter written to the players featuring in the Indian Premier League, the chief operating officer of the richest T20 league in the world, Mr. Hemang Amin, reiterated broadly on two things. First, the need on ensuring players' logistics post the completion of the Indian Premier League. And secondly, the additional safety through bio-bubbles. And Mr. Hemang Amin also thanked the players for bringing smiles on the faces of millions of cricket fans in these trying and testing times. Prior to this internal letter, players like Ravi Ashwin, Adam Zampa, Kane Richardson, Andre Tai opted out of IPL owing to COVID-19 pandemic and the bio bubble. Further, Chris Lynn had also raised concerns over the travel back to Australia after the completion of IPL. While the IPL is taking place, the mood of the country has not been cheerful. In such painful times, the pandemic has led to questions over the very idea of the IPL, that is sports plus entertainment. A tournament which previously used to bring excited crowds to the grounds and the TV sets. This revenue-generating two-month-long event seems unnecessary during the times of great human tragedy. So is it right to continue with the 14th edition of the Indian Premier League? Well, cancelling the Indian Premier League is definitely debatable because there is a section which really looks forward to the Indian Premier League. It consumes IPL as a distraction from the existing hardship. The mega event keeps the fans in home during such times. There are definitely a lot on social media who engage in the IPL as it offers some relief. It's also important to understand the IPL from an economic point of view. In fact, BCCI contributed 51 crore Indian rupees to the PM CARES Fund last time in March 2020. And further, just to give a context, BCCI paid approximately 3,500 crore Indian rupees as tax from 2007-08 till 2017, that is during the 10 years of IPL. That is as good as central government giving free vaccines to the entire south of India, or in fact, the entire country of Pakistan. Now, this is direct tax which BCCI pays. There are a lot of indirect tax receipts to the government through hotel bookings, flights, etc., adding to the revenue receipts of the government, which keeps the ball rolling. Also, there is a belief that while on one side citizens are struggling to find beds, oxygen and medicines in hospitals, IPL is completely cut off from the reality. This comes from the expectation that IPL as a system can do. It can be through a combination of players, franchises and the BCCI itself. Let's say a total contribution of 20% of player salary, which is approximately a good 100 crores from one season. This is just one example. IPL can do a lot, in fact a lot, in indirect manner too. The image of the Indian Premier League has come under a spot in the last few days. Like any other industry who are keeping the show going on through the flexible shifts, reduced production and so on, BCCI too cancelled one of its premier tournament, the Ranji Trophy, which did not take place last year. Such domestic 5-day tournament not only provides an aspiring cricketer a chance to showcase his skills, but also is an income source for him. In fact, around 70% of BCCI's annual income is spent on domestic tournaments, stadium maintenance and percolated down to the 34-seat associations, while 30% is retained for players' payment. All of this has been impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. It is critical to know that the players play the game for the love and passion. Money of course does mean to them, but it is the byproduct. Hence the privilege of playing sport in these testing times must be respected by the players, and act of responsibility by the players and the IPL will go a long way towards fulfilling their social responsibility. The BCCI, the players and the stakeholders involved will have a huge task in the coming days. Responsibilities and expectations will be huge. In all these, they will be shout for the cancellation of the IPL as well. How will the stakeholders react? What do you have to say? Do you think the IPL should continue in these challenging times? Do let us know in the comment box.
Check our other whiteboard style cricket videos backed by deep research. Kindly subscribe to our channel and help us grow. Thank you.